These inspectors have to criticize the railway board, even the highest officers in the railway administration. And now if they are transferred back, we can imagine the situation when even the report of a committee which was appointed with the knowledge of Parliament and on which so many persons served is being shelled and suppressed. Do you think that any independent inspection notes will ever see the light of the day? They say that in case of major accidents, we can have judicial inquiries. Inspection is one thing, and an inquiry into a major accident is another. The inspectorate that exists now is absolutely necessary, and it must be absolutely independent so that it can criticize the railway board or even the highest of the officers, the chief engineer or the general manager of the railway concerned. As for judicial inquiries, if they are necessary, by all means have them. I have been an advocate of it. I have been associated all my life with judiciary. I have risen from a magistrate. I started my career as a magistrate, and I would always advocate judicial inquiry when it is necessary. But certainly judicial inquiry cannot replace inquiry of a technical nature. And if you have a judicial inquiry, you will always want some technical experts to be the assessors or to be given an independent view. Do you want the officers of the railway ministry to be assessors, or do you want independent assessors? These government inspectors would be absolutely independent assessors in those judicial inquiries. This is just one part of it. There are at least half a dozen important matters which should be referred to. I will now refer to another matter on which fortunately the original committee and the reviewing committee are in agreement. I am not concerned with this or that committee. I am concerned only with the safety of travelling, and I very much welcome that there is agreement on some points which I consider to be very important, and that is about the adequate and full supplies of stores essential for safety and good performance. If you read the recommendations of both these committees, you will find that this serious lag has been responsible for a lot of inefficiency, for some of the accidents, and for keeping our personnel idle for a long time. Even the Shroff committee made a point of it, but the government machinery is such that no progress has been made in this matter, with the result that the efficiency of the railway administration has suffered.